guys happy to be here?
Yeah.
Yes. Okay, so today we are preparing for Christmas Eve service. So what our objective today is we have to try to make a live nativity. One that is going to really work on Christmas Eve. Can you help me out here?
Yep.
I'm like running out of ideas. We have to create one and make it look very realistic, okay?
Okay.
All right, but first, on our Advent countdown, what day are we? How many more days till Christmas?
21!
21 more days. We're taking off the number 21. I cannot wait to hear how you are celebrating and counting down for Christmas. All right, so Helena, Joan, and Kaylin, we got to get to work, okay? So go find things that you can create a live nativity with. Ready, set, go!
Okay, I got the cradle. Helena, you need a bathroom.
I need a bathroom, okay.
Okay, so we have Mary and Joseph. What are we missing?
Baby Jesus.
Oh, Jesus! Yes, we need. We can't have a live nativity scene without baby Jesus. Let's see.
That's a little big.
Yeah. That's okay. Yeah, that's not gonna work. Yeah. Well, let's see what else we got.
It's also a little big.
Okay, so you probably want to sleep with those stuffies, right? So
yeah.
We probably can't use them in our live nativity scene. Okay, what else can we try? I mean, we tried the stuffies. You probably want to sleep with them, so then they're just going to, like, leave the manger. We can't use that. What else can we use?
Let's see.
Oh, that's perfect.
That's pretty
baby
good.
Baby Jesus,
pretty
right? Good. How do you feel about that, Helena, if we took this and used this as our live nativity? Could your baby doll go with us? Oh, no? You don't want him to leave house? Okay. All right, so we got to find something that can leave home and go in our live nativity scene. What do you think? Some chips? Okay. All right, yeah. So I see that chips probably aren't going to work as baby Jesus because people are going to eat them. Okay. What else do we have?
I'm still eating.
You're still eating the chips?
Yep.
Oh. All right. What do you think baby Jesus should be? I wonder what they're going to pick.
Huh.
Doesn't seem like things are working out very well at this live nativity, trying to figure this out.
Maybe a rabbit?
What do you think, Joseph? We find
I don't know.
Something that will... Okay.
No, cat!
I'm kidding!
All right, I don't think the cat is going to work as baby Jesus. Let's try again. Let's find something.
I a
really
rabbit?
Need you guys' help. A rabbit?
A rabbit? I don't know.
I don't know
work.
About that.
I'm still here.
Mary's not going anywhere, huh?
Yep.
Yeah.
Do you think Mary wore goggles?
No.
No? She didn't? What do you think she wore?
No hat.
Oh, no hat? You don't think she had? She didn't have a covering over her head?
Yeah, because Joseph didn't have it either. And Mary is the same.
Oh, okay. Oh, you literally got the rabbit. Well, do you think the bunny will work?
No.
I don't know, guys. She might hop
she's
out of there.
She's moving around a lot.
She might not want to stay in there. Do you think she will?
It's a rabbit. Not bunny.
I don't know if she will want to stay in there all night.
Yeah, that would be a long time for a rabbit.
Yeah.
It just seems like everything we're trying to put in as baby Jesus isn't really working, is it?
Yeah.
No. I wonder what this...
A blanket?
A blanket? But then there's no baby Jesus, yeah. Right? We need a baby Jesus with a blanket, right? But everything we seem to put in there, we need to take back out, or it only lasts a little while. Like, the cat didn't last very long, did it?
We set her in, she jumped right out.
Yes, and I don't think Rosie or Benny here is going to last very long. Do you think so?
No.
No, she'll probably jump out very soon, right?
He's trying to figure out a way out.
Yes. So I think that we need to go back to the drawing board and figure out what we're going to use
as baby Jesus. Because ultimately, I think we're learning a big lesson here.
I know. A Lego guy.
A Lego guy? That would be kind of small. People wouldn't be really able to see it, would it? Well, the thing is...
A Lego friend?
Maybe Lego friends. But the thing is that we try to replace Jesus with other things in our lives, don't we? Mm-hmm. So we're going to hear more about that. So hold tight.
So boys and girls, as we see as the kids try to create a nativity scene, that they were trying to find baby Jesus, something that would resemble Jesus. And they continue to replace Jesus with all different things. But did any of them last? No. Even if we were able to use Helena's baby doll, it would have never lasted. Why? Because it's a solid thing. It doesn't breathe. It doesn't eat. It's not a savior. And so oftentimes we replace so much in our lives. We try to replace Jesus with it. And nothing can replace him. He is our savior and he loves us so much. He came as a baby, the lowest of low. He emptied himself out of his divine rights at that time to be humbly below everything. He wasn't born in a palace in this glorious getting honor as he should as a king. What was he? He was born in a barn, in a manger, laying in hay, smelly cows and sheep all around him. But he loved us so much to do that. Why? So that we could have a savior, so that we could have eternal life through him. And to fulfill those prophecies that we heard that Isaiah spoke last week at Hello Future. He loves us so much to do that for us, so that we can have our sins forgiven. How often do we replace things in our lives with Jesus? You know, hoping that something else will fulfill us during this time. How many times did we replace reading our Bibles with playing a video game? How many times did we replace talking bad about somebody instead of praying for them? Oftentimes we replace things in our lives, especially when we're under stress and we look around and we just don't find any hope. We replace things, empty things, things that don't mean anything, things that can be thrown away instead of grabbing hold of Jesus. And that's our mission today, is to really look at how much Jesus loved us. He loved us so much to come to this world and to be our Savior. And so we just are so grateful for that today. And that, knowing that he loved us so much, brings us the hope that we learned about last week. It's so amazing. So let's take a moment and light our candles. So we have two candles already, right? We have hope from last week, and then we have love. And looking at our Advent candle, we realize how much Jesus brought to us by being born in a manger in the lowest of low places. Could you imagine how Mary felt? It's amazing to know that she gave birth to a Savior. And today, he can be your Savior too. All we have to do is ask him into our hearts. And we can also find that same hope. And we can internalize and feel that love that he has for us. So take a few minutes and ask Jesus into your heart. And if you did today, feel free to comment or email us here at the church. We'd love to hear about it. And we love to give you resources to help you on your walk with God this Christmas season. So, boys and girls, we love you so much. Jesus loves you. And we will see you next week for our third week of Advent.